the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of God, who has delivered us from the dominion of darkness and made a place for us in the kingdom of his beloved Son, we welcome you. As we meet to celebrate again the coming of God's kingdom, we here reveal the mystery of God's loving purpose for us. How that when we were far off, he met us in his Son and brought us home. How he humbled himself to take our human nature, that we might share his divine glory. Let us then so celebrate this coming with our carols and hymns of praise, that our lives may be charged with his life, that we may hear witness to his glory and so bring light to those who sit in darkness. So first, we pray for those among whom the Christ was born, the poor and helpless, the aged and young children, the cold, the hungry, and the homeless, the victims of poverty, injustice, and oppression, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the unloved, those in despair or in the shadow of death. Then as we hear again the message of peace on earth and goodwill among all his people, we pray for the leaders of our nation, that all may be inspired to work together for the establishment of justice, freedom, and peace, and that we may bear true witness to this hope in a divided world. We pray for the peace and unity of Christ's body, the universal church, that the whole earth may live to praise his name. Let us pray in this season and reflect on the coming of Christ who brings light to the world. Let us leave behind the darkness of sin, walk in the light that shines on our path, and renew within ourselves the hope of glory to which he beckons us. And as we turn towards the light, let us have on our hearts all those who see no light, for whom all is darkness and despair. Let us pray that they too may be illuminated by Christ, who is our light. Finally, as we rejoice with the saints in heaven and on earth, we remember all who have gone before us with the signs of faith, whose hope was in the world made flesh, Jesus Christ, our Lord, through whom we offer up our prayers for the coming of his kingdom. In the words he himself has taught us, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
First lesson is taken from Book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 8 to 15 and 17 to 19. And they heard the sound of Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And Adam and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. Then the Lord God called to Adam and said to him, Where are you? So he said, I heard your voice in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself. And he said, Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you that you should not eat? Then the man said, The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me of the tree, and I ate. And the Lord God said to the woman, What is this you have done? The woman said, The serpent deceived me, and I ate. So the Lord God said to the serpent, Because you have done this, you are cursed more than all cattle, and more than every beast of the field. On your belly you shall go, and you shall eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. He shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. Then to Adam he said, because you have heeded the voice of your wife, and you have eaten from the tree of which I commanded you, saying, you shall not eat it, cursed is the ground for your sake. In toil you shall eat of it all the days of your life. Both thorns and thistles it shall bring forth for you, and you shall eat the herb on the field. In the sweat of your face you shall eat bread, till you return to the ground, for out of it you were taken. For dust you are, and to the dust you shall return. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Second lesson is taken from Genesis chapter 22 verses 15 to 18. Then the angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time out of heaven and said, by myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this thing and have not withheld your son, your only son. Blessing, I will bless you, and multiplying, I will multiply your descendants as the stars of the heaven and as the sea which is on the seashore. And your descendants shall possess the gate of their enemies. In your seed all the nations of the earth shall be blessed, because you have obeyed my voice. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Until the sun arises.
Taken from Isaiah chapter 9, verse 2 and 6 to 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in the land of the shadow of death, upon them a light has shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be upon his shoulder. And his name will be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. Upon the throne of David and over his kingdom, to order it and establish it with judgment and justice, from that time forward, even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Of the sun and the rising of the
Lesson is taken from Isaiah chapter 11 verses 1 to 4 and 6 to 9. There shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of counsel and might, the spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord. His delight is in the fear of the Lord, and he shall not judge by the sight of his eyes, nor decide by the hearing of his ears. But with righteousness he shall judge the poor, and decide with equity for the meek of the earth. He shall strike the earth with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. The wolf also shall dwell with the lamb. The leopard shall lie down with the young goat. The calf and the young lion and the fatling together. And a little child shall lead them. The cow and the bear shall graze. Their young ones shall lie down together. And the lion shall eat straw like the ox. The nursing child shall play by the cobra's hole, and the weaned child shall put his hand in the viper's den. They shall not hurt nor destroy in all my holy mountain, for the earth shall be full of knowledge of the Lord as the waters covers the sea. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Say another. Lesson taken from the Gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 to 35 and 38. Now in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph. Of the house of David, the virgin's name was Mary. And having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at this saying, but considered what manner of greeting this was. Then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bring forth a son and shall call his name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David. And he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." Then Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know a man?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Highest will overshadow you. Therefore, also that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God." Then Mary said, "Behold, the Maid servant of the Lord, let it be to me according to your word. And the angel departed from her. This is the word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Lesson is taken from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 2, verses 1 to 7. And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. This census first took place while Quirinius was governing Syria. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth into Judea to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. So it was that while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus, lay down his grief. The seventh lesson is taken from the Gospel according to Luke, chapter 2, verses 8 to 16. Now there were in the same country shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And behold, an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be the sign to you. You will find a babe wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." So it was when the angel had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said to one another, "Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us." And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Child, holy, The eighth lesson is taken from Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 to 12. Wise men from the east. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who has been born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. When Herod the king heard this, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. So they said to him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the rulers of Judah, for out of you shall come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel. Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search carefully for the young child, and when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also. When they heard the king, they departed, and behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A tiny star. The ninth lesson is taken from the Gospel according to St. John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him nothing was made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not comprehend it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. This man came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was a true light, which gives light to every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become children of God, to those who believe in his name, who were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. This is the Word of God.
Thanks be to God.
Joyful are the angels. meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face. May the rain fall soft upon your fields. And until we meet again, may God hold you, may God hold you in the palm of His hand. Devyan vahantege murdu davatat karunavatat tapyob bahar karamu. උන්වහන්ස ඔබගේ යාම් මීම් රැකවල් කරන සේක්වා සැමදා ඔබට ආශිර්වාද කරන සේක්වා උන්වහන්සේ සුවකී මුහුණේ බැල්ම ඔබ වෙත හෙලා ඔබට හැමදා කරුණා කරන සේක්වා අරවෙල්ලාම් කඩන්ත කඩවලින් සමාදානම් උංගල් මනමෙල්ලාම් නිරයට්ටුම් කඩවලින් අවර් මයින්දන් යේසු ක්‍රිස්තුයිම් පත්‍රියාරුයිලුම් අන්බිලුම් අද උංගලේ නිලෙක් කොල්ලත් සෙයුට්ටම් தந்தை மைந்தன் புனிதாவியான வராகிய அனைத்து வல்ல கடவுளின் ஆசி எப்போதும் உங்களோடு இருப்பதாக